The genie is out of Google DeepMind's bottle, and it's incredible. This new paper showcases genie that can make interactive, playable environments from just taking one image as input. And all this is even more incredible because the model trained on internet videos without any supervision. I hope you are as curious to find out how the authors pull this off as Miss Coffee Bean is. Grab a cup of coffee, because in this AI coffee break we will explain the magic behind Genie. Okay, so imagine this. You take a real-world photo or hand-draw a sketch or use text-to-image generation to produce an image, and the Genie model will do its magic and produce real-time frames that correspond to your movement. Okay, I know Genie version 1 produces small images, not so high resolution, and short interactions overall, and it can hallucinate. But just as we have seen the evolution of text-to-image models in just a few years, from DALL-E 1 to DALL-E 2 to now DALL-E 3, please be patient with this technology and wait a few years. Because imagine how producing minigames or even larger games could become less a matter of experts or large studios. With Genie, anyone with the right prompting techniques could produce a minigame. Also, this could have applications to robotics. As the authors also showcase, Genie that can watch robots do actions, infer the actions, and control the robot. Or imagine the quality of videos produced by OpenAI's Sora, but made interactive the way that Genie works. That could be something we could see in a few years. Okay, enough hype. Now let's see how Genie produces generative interactive environments and how it learned to produce interactive videos without any action or text annotations, just from the internet. Genie trained on over 200,000 hours of gaming videos from the internet. It has 11 billion parameters, which is relatively small for today's standards, but it should be small, since it's supposed to generate a likely visual continuation on a frame-by-frame basis. At inference, the model takes the action of the user and the previous frames to generate the next frame. Genie has three important components: a video tokenizer that converts raw video frames into discrete tokens, a latent action model that infers what action could have taken place between pairs of frames, so this is a helper module that learns actions unsupervised by just watching YouTube, and third, a dynamics model that predicts the next frame of the video from a latent action and past frame tokens. We explain now how these components train and how they work together. The video tokenizer is an autoencoder, which works like this. It takes in T frames of video, so T images, an encoder which has an ST transformer architecture, which we'll explain in a bit, reduces their dimensionality of the input frames. Because it is a VQVAE, it reduces the dimension to discrete representations, so basically the encoder is not allowed to map to any embedding vector in the lower dimensional space, 32 dimensions here, but it must choose between 1024 embeddings whose values it learns during training. Then an ST transformer decoder reconstructs these frames, and this thing is trained to reconstruct the video frames it gets as input. Now, what is that ST transformer that is the architecture of the encoder and the decoder? An ST transformer, which stands for spatio-temporal transformer, unlike normal transformers, has two attention layers. The first attention layer is a spatial layer that attends within the same frame to all different pixels, while the second attention layer is an important temporal layer that attends at the same pixels across all T frames. Importantly, the computation complexity in the spatial attention layer scales linearly and not quadratically like normal attention layers, which makes it efficient in this video generation setting, as it does not take that much longer to compute a video with many frames. Now, how to model the actions that should come in for predicting the next frame? Especially since action labels are rarely available in internet videos, there are some players who show their controls while playing games, but the majority doesn't. So the authors decide to learn latent actions fully unsupervised. Again, an ST transformer acts as an encoder that takes as input all previous frames up to the current frame T, but also the next frame T plus 1. It outputs one latent action from a set of 8 possible actions. These actions are not yet button presses, because the whole idea is to discover them in an unsupervised way. But the model will discover meaningful actions because the decoder only has access to that action and the history to reconstruct the next frame. So it should encode meaningful changes in that action A between frames. So the 8 possible values of A are learned during training, and because the authors let the model choose from 8 possible actions, it's unsurprising that it maps to 8 actions like left, right, up and down, jumping, and who knows what else, which are needed for the basic platformer games that Genie currently can create. Then an ST Transformer decoder looks at this encoded action and the historic frames to decode the next frame, T+1. To say the same thing in more technical terms, the latent action model is trained like a VQVAE with a codebook size of 8. But this whole latent action model is just for discovering meaningful actions during training. Because at inference, the authors can discard everything but the learned actions codebook and generate frames with the dynamics model. The dynamics model is just a decoder. It takes in the tokenized video from the video tokenizer, the actions from the latent action model, and predicts the tokens of the next frames. Here the architecture is again based on an ST transformer that works like the mask git architecture, which we explained in detail in the Funaki video at minute 9:33. So to summarize what we said there, the authors randomly mask input tokens and reconstruct them not all at once, but in a few steps. How is this modular beast trained? Well, the authors train the video tokenizer first because it is needed by the dynamics model. Then they train the latent action model directly on image pixels and the dynamics model on video tokens simultaneously. At inference, a user gives the model an image to serve as an initial frame. The video encoder of the video tokenizer tokenizes it. The player then tries to move in the environment, pressing one control, which maps to a discrete latent action. The dynamics model takes the video tokens, the action, and predicts the next frame tokens. This repeats to produce a whole sequence of video tokens, and then the video decoder decodes them all at once. So one needs to play a bit and move a bit, and only then frames come all at once after large T steps by the decoder. T, the sequence length should be 16 frames, so that is why the GIFs from the websites are so short. Or at least this is how I understand the paper. What do you think? It's a bit hazily formulated, and this kind of contrasts with the overall clarity of the paper. Let me know in the comments what you think. Well, this is how the authors generate these incredible demos, which sure are a bit low resolution, but look, Genie can produce parallax, which makes the foreground move more than the near and far middle ground, and the background moves only slightly. If you're not impressed yet, maybe this will help. Genie doesn't have to generate computer games all day. The authors trained a 2.5 billion parameter Genie model on the robotics dataset without action annotation, and Genie could infer the actions and control the robotic arm. One thing that is probably controversial is the issue of copyright. I'm sure Google did not pay the developers of the games that were seen by Genie in YouTube videos to train their model. So like in AI art, we will have to wait to see how the legal and ethical landscapes will adapt to these developments. We hope we could excite you about Genie with this video, at least a little bit. If you like this video, do not forget to like and subscribe, as we would love to see you with our next video. Also, check out our merch, maybe you find some cool designs for you. Okay, bye.